Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum. How are you, my dear students? I think all of you are well and good. By the grace of Almighty Allah, my dear students. In the previous class, we discussed about pie chart and central tendency. And you know, there are three main measurements of central tendency, and that are arithmetic mean, that means arithmetic average, median, and mode. My dear students, today we will discuss first arithmetic mean, then median, then mode. These are the very simplest method. I think already all of you know on your previous class, but at first write arithmetic mean. Arithmetic mean. Okay, my students, arithmetic mean what? I think all of you know that if the sum of the numerical values of data is divided by the number of data, is called arithmetic. So just write this: if the sum of the numerical values of data divided the number of data. Divided the number of data, that is sum of xi divided by n. Sum of xi divided by n is called arithmetic mean of arithmetic average. Arithmetic mean of arithmetic average. This is very simple. Okay, what I said? I said sum of xi divided by n. Look at me here. Sum of xi. What is I? I is an integer number. Its value since I equal 1 to 1 to, you just write 1 to n. 1 to n, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 divided by n. Suppose you have 5 data. How many data? 5 data. So you just write x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus x4 plus 5. How many data here? 5. So number of data is 5. This is the expression to find out the arithmetic mean. Very simple. Okay, my dear students, arithmetic mean you just solve arithmetic mean in two ways: when you have given organized data and when you have given unorganized data. Clear, my dear students? When you have organized data, you solve a particular method, and when you have given unorganized data, you also have some other way. But my dear students, at first you know when you have given unorganized data, that means you have unorganized data. You just use it here, unorganized data. Then your given data is called xi. Your given data, unorganized data, number one, your given data is called xi. Clear? And your given frequency number is sorry, what they are going to call is FI. Then number 3, we find out, you find out at first FI into XI. Understand? Number 4, after find out the total sum of FI XI, you divided this value by total number of data or total number of frequency number that is FI XI divided of N, where N means sum of FI. Here N means sum of FI. When you have given organized data, you just follow these four formulas. Understand? Okay, my students, the next one, when you have given organized data. Organized data. You must follow this formula 1. Firstly, you find class mean value. Class mean value of all particular class interval. Yes, and that is called XI. Number 2, you have given on your, you have given frequency number 1 year person, that is FI. Number 3, now you multiply FI into XI. Number 4, you add all the value of FI XI. Number 5, the sum of FI XI is divided the number of the sum of a pi x I is divided the number of frequency number. Understand? That is sum of f I x I divided by n, where n is sum of f I, where n is sum of the frequency number. That complete your arithmetic mean. This is very simple or not? I think this is very simple. Okay, my students. Now we discussed about median. Okay. Numbers that are 23, 11, 25, 15, 21, 12, 17, 18, 22, 27, 29, 30, 16, and 19. My students, these are your unorganized data. Clear? Okay. And find the not only median, also mode. Yeah. Okay. Understands. If you have given this type of question, at first you arrange this data into lower to higher or higher to lower. Okay, understands. I just make this lower to higher. In which way? In lip chart pathodi. In lip chart method. Okay, my students, lip chart method. Here you just see the all your given data have only two digits that are 1, 2, 3, 4 and etc. So at first write 1, then make an arrow sign, then 2, then 3. Is there an extra? No extra. So first time is 23. So you put here 3. Then 25, then 15, then 21, then 12, then 17, then 18, then 22, then 27, then 29, then 30, then 16, then 19. Look at me, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. You have given 14 data and I just write this. Look at it. Now we arrange the given data smaller to larger, and that is look at me. That is 2A. 1, this means 11. This means 12. This means 15. That means 16. That means 17. That means 19. That means 21. That means 22. That means 23. That means 25. That means 27. That means 29. That means documents. Now we count the number of data. How many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So you find here 40 is an even number. So median. When you have when you have given, look at me, when this is not your solution, plus formula, when you have given even numbers of data, you can numbers of data, even numbers of data, the formula for formula, the formula to find median is, look at me, median is n by 2 term plus n by 2 term plus, look at me, n by 2 term plus n by 2 plus on term divided by 2, understand? Divided by 2. Look at me, my dear students. Here, this is a formula. Okay, my dear students, this is the formula for even numbers. Okay, my dear students, you count these numbers and got even numbers. So, how many data gets? 14. So, the value of n is 14. So, look at me, 14 by 2 terms. Plus, look at me, n by 2, 14 by 2 plus 1, that means 14 by 2 plus on divided by 2, look at me, 14 by 2 means 7 term, you count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, that is 21, plus 14 by 2, 7 plus 1, 8 term, 21 plus 22, 21 plus 22. Clear, students? This is very simple. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Look at me. There is a mistake. And that is. Okay, sorry. Here is 18. Here is 18. So, 7 term is 19 and 8 term is 21 divided by 2. That is 40 divided by 2. And that is. So median is 20. But understand, this is a particular solution for particular math. But the formula is another one. Yeah. Okay. You just solve this. But I just use this. Okay. The number 2. When you have given even numbers to data, this is your formula. But when you have given odd numbers. For numbers data, formula is, look at me, by just follow this n by 2 plus on star. Understand? Okay, understand? Suppose I just erase this one. How many data here? I just erase this one. How many data here? Here, the number of data is 30. Even odd number, this is an odd number, yes or no? Yes. So your formula is n by 2 plus 1, that means 13. I am really sorry. N plus 1 divided by 2, that is 13 plus 1 divided by 2. Clear? 13 plus 1, that means 14 by 2, that is 7th term. 7th term, look at me, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, that is. Understand? This is very simple. Okay, my students. Now, I just erase all this. Okay. There is no mode value because what is called mode? Mode is called the highest frequency number is called mode. Okay. Look at me. Mode. In this question, there is no mode. All these are only one types. All the data are given here only one type. So there is no mode here. So what is mode? is the highest frequency number?
Mode is the highest frequency number, I think.
Okay, the number quiz. The number quiz. Quiz appears maximum time, month time. Appears maximum time is the mode of the data of the data of the data. That means suppose you have six data. You have six data, and that is 7, 9, 8, 7, 7, 9. Look at the how many data here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So at first you arrange lower to higher or higher to lower. But I think all of you arrange this item of data in smaller to greater, or that means lower to higher. So what is the higher, lowest value of this? 7, 7, 7. Then 8, then 9, then 9. Look at my students. In which data the topmost? This 7 is here 3 times. Sometimes 3 times. This is only 1 times. And this is 2 times. 2 times. So I said the number which appears maximum time is the mode. Here 7 appears 3 times, 9 appears 2 times, 8 appears 1 times. 1 times. Which appears maximum times? 7. So 7 is the mode of the given data. Given data. Clear my students? I think all of you understand. Clear my students? Okay. No more today, my students. This is the last class of your vacation. I think if your class open, we will meet in your class. Otherwise, we start after vacation of Eid ul Fitr. We start our class. My students, everyone do your homework properly. Understand, my students? Okay. And I pray for you. I think all of you pray for me also.